I welcome you all to this problem solution series in digital electronics. I am solving the problems from the book Digital Design by Maurice Mann and Michael Cilletti. So in this video, I am solving the problem number 6.23 from the chapter number 6. So the problem is, design a timing circuit which provides an output signal that stays on for exactly 8 clock cycles. Okay, that means this circuit output will remain in the on state for 8 clock cycles after getting the start signal. So a start signal sends the output to one state, and after 8 clock cycles, the signal returns to zero state. So we have to keep in mind that we have to wait for 8 clock cycles, then we can reset the output to zero, or we can clear the output to zero. So for designing this circuit, we have to wait for 8 clock cycles. So for 8 clock cycles, we can use a 3-bit counter. So a 3-bit counter has a maximum count of 8, okay, 8 number of counts. That is, the count sequence is from 000 to 111. So we have to use this counter along with a flip-flop. Okay, so for this example, I will use here a T flip-flop. So first of all, let us assume here we have a 3-bit counter here. Suppose here we have this 3-bit counter. So it will have 3 output ports or output values, and it will have 3 input values. Okay, so the output values are suppose A2, A1 and A0. Okay, and the input values are I2, I1 and I0. Suppose we have this logic 0 connected to all of these 3 inputs. So logic 0. Here we'll have one count input, one load input, and one clock input. Okay, clock, and one active low clear input. And here we'll use another T flip-flop. Suppose this is the T flip-flop. Here we have T input, here we have clock input. Okay, suppose we have active low clock input here. Okay, that means this flip-flop will work on the, or this flip-flop will be activated on the negative edge of this clock signal. Okay, that means whenever we have a 1 to 0 transition, this flip-flop will change its output according to its input. Okay, so here we have this output. Suppose this is Y. Then here we have a, suppose active low start signal. Start signal. According to the question, this output of the flip-flop will change to one state. Okay, suppose initially the output is, it is zero. Okay, so here we have zero initially. So whenever we have a start signal here, okay, so this output will change from zero to one. Okay, as per the question, we will feedback this output of this T flip-flop to this count input. That means whenever we have a 1 here at this output, this 1 is feedback to this counter input, that is count input. Whenever we have count equal to 1, this flip-flop will start counting. Suppose initially we have the output is 000. Now here we'll use a NAND gate, okay, 3 input NAND gate. So this NAND gate output will be connected to this clock input. Now let us understand the operation of this circuit. So when we have this start signal, this output was initially 0, so it will go from 0 to 1. When start is equal to 0, suppose, so what will happen? Y is changing from 0 to 1. It will be set. Okay, because in the question it is given that a start signal sends the output to 1. So when we have 1 at this output, so this 1 will be connected, applied here at this input. Okay, so here we'll have 1. Suppose here we have 1 at this logic. Suppose here we have logic 1, okay, at this T input. So whenever we have an active low signal, that is, whenever we have a 1 to 0 transition, this output of the flip-flop will change. So when we have 1 here, this flip-flop will start counting. With each clock pulse, this flip-flop output will be incremented by 1. Okay, so whenever we have these, all these 3 inputs are 1, 1 and 1, That means starting from 000, then it will go to 001, then 010, then 011100, and so on. And whenever we have 111, that is 7, that means after 8 clock cycles, what will happen? We'll have 111 here. So when we have 111 here, this output will be feedback to this clock input. So previously you can see that whenever any one of the input is 0, this clock input is high. When we have 111 at this output will be, previously it was 1, now it will be 0. So when we have a 1 to 0 transition at this input, clock input, this flip-flop will be activated. When this flip-flop is activated, this toggle input is 1, logic 1. So what will happen? This previous output, it will change, okay, or it will complement the previous output. So it will change from 1 to 0. So when we have 0 at this input, so what will happen? Count equal to 0. That means this flip-flop will now stop counting and it will remain in the same state, 111. And whenever we have 111, so that means it will remain in the same state. That means from 0 to 0, there is no transition. This flip-flop will be deactivated. Suppose if we have a clock signal, suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. These are the 10 clock pulses. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Suppose here at this point we have got the start signal. Whenever we have got the start signal, this output will have a transition from 0 to 1. That means from 0 to 1, this output Y will be having a transition from 0 to 1. And it will remain in the same state up to 8 clock, because from 000 to 111, there are 8 clock cycles. Okay, so when this 8 clock cycle is complete, at this counter output will have 111. Okay, so whenever we have 111, this output will be 0. So here we have an active low signal. That means this D flip-flop will be activated. Okay, so whenever this D flip-flop will be activated and this logic 1 input at the T input, okay, so the previous output will be complemented, that is it will go to 0. So after getting this 8 clock cycle, it will go to 0 and remain in this same state. So this is the timing circuit which provides this output signal Y that will remain in the 1 state for 8 clock cycle. Okay, here you can see it is remaining the 1 state for 8 clock cycles, and after 8 clock cycle it will go to 0. Here you can see that in this question, after 8 clock cycle the signal returns to 0. That means the output goes to 0 again. So this is the solution of the problem number 6.23. Thank you for watching. If you have any question, please put it in the comment section below. Also like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.